How's the beard? It's not interfering? Sometimes it does. Hi, how are you? I'm Dan Rue speaking here live. Noah, come closer, Noah. Come closer.
How's it going?
Yes, I'm Dan Rue and Noah. Noah, let me ask you a couple questions.
Sure.
Any relation to the biblical Noah?
Yeah, he's my great-great-great-great-great-grandfather, you know?
You basically saved the world, low-key.
I don't like to take credit for it, but yeah, I did.
I'm Dan Rue.
We got a roll?
Oh, we got a roll?
We got a roll.
Oh, shit.
Okay, I'm gonna just roll. You wanna take a seat?
Yo, yo, yo,
yo,
D.
What's up, Rowdy?
The birthday boy.
How'd you know?
It's my job to know. And honestly, the beard, man. I'm just loving the beard.
Thanks, man. I appreciate you.
I feel like the beard is low-key on James Harden's level of beard.
People don't realize I've had the beard before James. But no debate. No competition. I'm just saying.
I feel like he got it from you, low-key.
I think he did.
Where are you from, Dan?
Man, I'm from Louisiana.
Louisiana.
The Southern hospitality style of love. I love it. I was born in Lafayette, Louisiana. I lived in Baton Rouge for like 10 years and moved to LA about 3 years ago.
Oh, so it's been 3 years?
I'm still new.
You got here, bro, and went viral like 3 years ago, bro. So it's just like you got here and it was just boom. So did you meet Nick first or did you meet Odell first?
You know what? I met Odell first, actually.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, guys who don't know, me and Odell have been friends for about 8 years now. I met him when he was coming into college at LSU. Mm. We met at a bar.
It was just like bro love at first sight almost.
That's my dog, man.
Your dog? I feel that.
We talk all the time.
So give me the whole come up, man. Talk to me about that whole thing.
You know, it's crazy. A lot of people don't know this. About 4.5 years ago, mm-hmm. I was pretty much homeless, bro. I was sleeping in an old Jeep that I had. I lost the little job I had. Odell would always tell me, he's like, bro, you're meant for much more. And it was tough for me because I didn't know where I was going to go in life. I was literally traveling back and forth, clubs in Louisiana with my little Jeep. I would drive and they would pay me maybe $100 just to come turn up in the club. And I started building a little Instagram. You know, it was a hustle for months and months and months and months. Towards the end of that year, I asked Nick, I was like, yo, could I stay by you for like a couple weeks on your couch? He's like, yeah, it's cool. I was like, let's do some videos, you know?
Wow.
We did some videos. I was like, hey, just let me be me, hold the camera. Say, you know, what you doing?
What you doing, baby?
We basically put everything together and it just blew up.
Yeah, baby. What is you doing, baby? They got a basketball court, Dan. You're not No, Dan. Dan, you was... Oh, my God, baby. Dan, baby, where is you going, baby? This Michael Jordan house, baby? No, don't tell me it's Michael Jordan house, baby.
World star picked it up. Mm-hmm. Chris Brown was posting everything. I believe if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be where I'm at today. He was posting all of our videos.
Dang.
The day he tagged me that next year on my birthday, I got 200,000 followers in 24 hours.
200,000 followers?
In 24 hours. Like, what? It was crazy. It was like, I got like 400,000 followers that week. It was crazy, man. It was such a blessing, man. From LA, just working my booty off. I'm in 2K.
You're in 2K.
I have a little small special on Netflix with Nick. I did Wildin' Out for 3 seasons. Shout out to Nick Cannon for that.
Nick Cannon's tough.
And just being a viral
Viral
guy,
sensation.
A viral sensation. That's where I'm at today. And I'm gonna keep be able to support my family by doing the thing I love, so.
For that, man, yeah. Carpe diem. Dance battle, El Bulls versus Dan Rue. I'm up first with the Millie Rock Challenge. Shout out to Ms. Brittany herself. Be going. Oof. 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 Let it go, let it go. It's your turn. What you got?
Yeah. I just do something light, you know, because I'm about to do you like Kobe. Toronto, 81. Okay. Sound familiar?
I'm not Jalen Rose, but all right.
It's cool.
Whatever you say.
81 olives?
Hey. 81 olives. Hey. Oh, wow. He's really bone breaking. Yeah. Okay. All right, bro. So I'm talking to this girl. I was just trying to hang out. I was trying to get out the friend zone, bro. You know what I mean?
Oh, you in the friend zone? See, oh, man.
I know.
Got to go to APU.
What's APU?
Applied Pressure University. You got to apply that pressure.
Apply that pressure.
That's the only way you get out the friend zone.
Can I call her, bro? Can you talk to her for me?
Go ahead.
Just don't take it up. You take it.
I like older women, bro. Good. Trust me.
I love to see that, bro.
You are good.
That grown man stuff.
You're all good, bro.
Yeah, yeah. Here it goes.
Talk to her, bro. Let me see what you do first.
Oh, shoot. That's for the fade. Yo.
Hello.
What's good?
What's up?
You look great today.
Thank you. I just got back from the gym.
Oh, okay, yeah. Let me see. You working?
You grinding?
How was your day today?
It was good.
It was straight?
I had class, worked out. Yeah, it was straight.
So you just vibe? Oh, whoa. APS. Yo, I need help, bro.
Hey, check this out. Listen to this.
He wants to know how he can get out of the friend zone.
The friend zone?
He said that you put him in the box of the friend zone.
First of all, the first step is not trying to get put on with all of my friends. Okay, right there. I think you need a crash course,
Kuz is already teaching the crash course. I can have him teach too.
I'm trying to help him. I think you should give him a chance.
All right, what are you trying to do then?
There you go.
Thank you.
What are you trying to do? Apply the pressure now.
Do you want to like go out and get like food or somewhere or something? Or?
Yeah, come down to Grub. Let's see.
What are some good eats?
Places where they make the food like right in front of you.
Like Subway.
I tried. I gave you the chance.
Oh, but no, I was just giving an option though. It ain't the only one.
Benihana.
Look, Benihana. Look. Benihana. Hey, on the house, on me, look. Benihana's, right? Is that cool?
Benihana's.
Some shrimp.
Now we're talking.
Yeah, we talking. You know, some chicken fried rice, right?
Some what fried rice?
I'll call you. I'm gonna hit you later though.
Sure.
I'll come scoop you. All right.
Okay, enjoy your crash course.
I'm gonna see you around.
All right.
See, you're talking too much.
I just
keep it as, yo, what are you doing? What are you trying to do?
Yeah.
Take you to dinner. Go to Benihana's. All right, cool. I'm chilling right now. I'm gonna call you on my way home. Good job though.
That really helped me out though. It's going
APU.
Professor Kuz. APU, you know. Yep. At Brooks University, we can be you and be yourself. It's your boy, Chef Books.
This is real, man. I don't know if you read this. This is real.
Fellas, this is how it's gonna go. We're each gonna take turns drafting items from the table right here. We're gonna draft until all the items are gone.
Then I get to pick the best smoothie.
Cool. Fellas, make sense?
Yep, we ready.
Who's gonna draft first?
It's gotta be chocolate.
Mm. Oh, chocolate.
Rock. Wasabi.
Wasabi.
Strawberries.
Yogurt. Strawberries?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with bananas.
Bananas?
Yogurt.
Yogurt.
I'm gonna go with blueberries.
Blueberries.
Grab a little bit of peanut butter.
Yeah. Peanut butter?
Paprika.
Paprika.
Paprika. Oak milk. Where does oak milk come from?
I'm not even sure.
Oak trees.
Does it really?
Yes.
I'm gonna go with the marinara sauce on
mine. Oh, my boy's
can't
getting saucy.
Can't go wrong with marinara sauce.
Coffee.
Pepper.
Walnuts.
Spinach.
Whey protein.
Black seed.
The white paper.
Yeah.
It's time to cook up this smoothie.
Add some of this yogurt in.
Gotta get that in there.
A little dab of oat milk.
Damn.
Ooh, I'm gonna throw a few of them strawberries in there.
Do it like a, ooh.
No, I got you. Don't worry, this is about to be Chef Boyardee's.
Yo, it's Chef Boyardee's, though. Don't trip on that.
Yes, we do it. Get way.
There we go.
Your shit smells nasty.
It does.
Oak.
The oak.
Oak milk.
Oak milk.
No.
Yeah. Oh!
One hand.
Hey.
Y'all thought it was a joke? Oh, you know, man. I do cook, ladies, so you know. One, two, three.
Nice, bro. There we go. Yes, sir.
So we've reached the grand finale of this all, where I'm gonna give both of these a shot and declare a winner. I have a bad feeling about both, but I'm looking forward to the experience.
No, don't have a bad feeling.
It's about the experience, bro.
Mmm, doesn't that just sound good?
This is L's smoothie. I'm gonna give this a shot. That's really bad. That's really awful. Chef Dan, thank you for your offering. Let's give it a quick taste.
All right.
That ain't bad. Wow.
That ain't bad.
There's no way.
Let's go.
Chef Bugs, Chef Dan, I'm gonna dip out. Thank you guys.
Thanks, Noah.
Yeah.
Such a good guy.
He's a great guy. Well, went down. The Slam Show, L Bugs, Dan Ru, you came through. Thanks for coming through. Getting lit, me and you, and we are signing off, man. Over.
You know, you can put some mix. I be putting mixes in mine. I be like,
I know, but you be on that heater. Hey!
Like that?
A little hot.
Heater. Oh, no, Dan, what you doing, baby? Dude. Before you be like,
hey.
He be
hitting
that joint. I love that joint. Like, you know, come with the.
Like that.
Come with the lick, though. The lick.
Oh, you be doing that,
you gotta add the lick. You don't add the lick, it's just not the right thing. Too short, the goat.
Backboard underhand.
Kobe jab, just like the little jab first. Wiggle, wiggle, go.
Oh, let's go. 40.
No way.
Right on the money.
Stay tuned.